For more on the consequences of the fiscal cliff, we're joined now by Robert Greenstein. He's the founder and president of the Center on Budget and Policy Priorities, which analyzes proposed budgets and tax policies with particular emphasis on low-income Americans. He's in our Washington Bureau. Good morning.
Good morning.
To begin with, you heard Speaker Boehner say we're at a stalemate. Do you think a deal is going to get done here in time?
I think a deal will definitely get done, but I'm not sure it'll be by January 1st. They may actually need to go into January and have the intense pressure from markets and others that puts on the policymakers to then get a deal maybe the first, second, or third week in January. Now, the only thing to say there is the adverse effects on the economy if we don't get a deal build and really take several months to have full effect. So while we really want a deal by January 1st, if they get a deal pretty quickly then in January and make it retroactive to January 1st, which I think they do, then the economy is still okay. The big problem is if we go months with no deal.
All the CEOs I talked to are saying there's already an impact here. There's uncertainty. They're not hiring. I've heard from a number of retailers who say, hey, if we don't have a deal by December 14th, this is not going to be a happy holiday for us. If things do go over the cliff, Robert, what happens and how significant is that going to be on the economy in the immediate term?
Well, actually, we probably are having a modest effect now, and it's not like it suddenly becomes dramatic on January 1st. It just gradually gets bigger over time. And we really have two issues threatening the economy here. The fiscal cliff on January 1st isn't the only one. About 2 months after that, we hit the debt limit again. The debt limit's different. If the United States defaults on its obligations for the first time in the history of the Republic, there is permanent serious damage to the U.S. dollar, to our currency, to our place in the world economy. And this is why I know the president in his last offer urged that we resolve both the fiscal cliff and the debt limit at the same time. What we don't want to do is go to the brink on the economy now and then threaten the economy again only 2 months later. We got to deal with both problems together in the weeks ahead for the good of the economy.
But there's also a cumulative psychological effect here, isn't it? If we don't deal with this quickly, it builds. It's already, as Rebecca pointed out, and you agreed, it's already starting, isn't it?
Yeah, I think there's a modest effect so far. I don't think it's dramatic. It's incremental. You know, the closer you get, the bigger it gets, and then it gets somewhat more serious after January 1st. The other side of the coin, I wish this weren't so, but to get movement, particularly on the Republican side, on the tax cuts for very high-income people, you know, which average, this is an average tax cut of $130,000 a year for people that make over $1 million a year. In my view, we can't afford that. But in any event, to get that kind of movement, we might actually need to go into early January. Maybe the stock market fluctuates a bit. There's great concern. If it's a big story in the media now, it's an even bigger story. That could occur. I remember in 95, there was an impasse and the government shut down.
Right.
Newt Gingrich, Bill Clinton. The pressure was so intense, there was then a settlement in 2 to 3 weeks.
All right.
Here, I think if we go into January, it'll be less than 2 to 3 weeks. It'll be fast.
We hope so. Robert Greenstein, thanks so much for being with us this morning.